How low can you go?
I'm David from Retro Rides, by the way.
How are you doing? I'm Craig. I'm with River City Rods and Fabrication.
Fantastic. Your truck is amazing.
Thank you very much.
Breaking the internet. So tell us about it and why you built it and what it's all about.
The customer actually just bought it off of us, and he said, hey, listen, you know, I'd like to just lower the thing and redo the interior. Well, the problem was the interior panels were all rotted out at the very base of this thing. So it must have been waterlogged at one time, and it just kind of destroyed itself. So ultimately, we ended up building this whole complete back half on this thing, and with the look in mind that it would be like the old style pickup that had a slide-in camper. You could pull the truck under it, and it'd be something that you could pull out of it at any time. So that was kind of the premise behind what was the look. The reason why we didn't just go with a regular bed or put something in there was because of the room. We have so much more room now with this setup that we have. So in this this engine is just just kind of like a little base 5.3, nothing major, a little bit of a cam in it. It's got a 4L80 transmission. As far as braking and stuff, we just went with a standard booster brake system. The front suspension is GSI, and then we had to do some little bit of modifications to it in order for it to accommodate the lowered stance and stuff like that. We pulled the control arms and so they were a little bit tighter as far as that goes, so the wheels tucked in a little bit more. You know, kind of moving on to like the paint and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's the paint is such a thing. It's so beautiful.
So this is these are all PPG product. The base is a waterborne product, and then we used a solvent-based product as far as for the rest of it. There's 6 coats of clear on this stuff, and then it allows you to not even feel a single stripe that's in there.
Yes, amazing.
Thank you.
And all the detail carries on underneath the bonnet as well, which is so nice.
Yeah, we just try to keep it very simple, just clean, nothing that was, that's going to scream at you and let the truck do the talking itself.
It really works really nice.
We went with modern glass on all the windows, so that way it just kind of, with the satin, the contrast between the satin and the gloss, it allows us to, identify, it is a secondary piece to the truck itself.
Yeah, but it keeps the metallic sheen through, which is just a really nice touch.
Yeah, we just dabbled
it. My favorite thing about when looking around, just there's so many nice little details that hold it all together.
Yeah, thank you.
I think you've done a beautiful job with that. Should we have a look at the interior?
Yeah, absolutely. So the way we did this interior was we've kind of given it a kind of like an old, bar, just kind of a loungy type theme is what we did. And, kind of going into it, we made this thing so it was a functional camper. So this basically what happens in here is this will slide out and make a bed.
Lovely.
Yeah, so we did that. We used, between cedar and copper and just various woods and things of that sort.
You keep like a nice material flavor.
You just keep the ambiance of what you're trying to create there. And that's, the sense of warmth and stuff like that. So, and then we did that with a kind of a crushed velvet look on here. And what we did is we ended up putting these on aluminum panels. And then what we did is we bead rolled all these things in. So that way we ended up getting that look. Kicker's been a great support for us. And so basically there's 8, 6.5 inch or 6.25 inch speakers. And then we had the 2 12 inch subs that we ended up going with here. And then it's just got a head unit that is controlled off of your USB or anything like that. I bought these liquor barrels and I thought that they were just brand new, whatever. Well, these were actually used whiskey barrels. And so what happens is you kind of get that, the whiskey smell when you're playing the stereo and when you're so it's kind of a neat.
That helps.
It's kind of cool.
It must be so fun to do an interior like this as well, because you can just add all the little details, like your sort of your copper cups and everything. You must be working on it and see a thing like, that's a thing we can do.
And that was so we had done a camper in 2017, somewhat similar. This one was more functional, and from the standpoint of, we've got microwave, we've got, refrigerators. This is basically a basin sink that the booze in or do whatever you're going to do.
That's your week supplies for SEMA sorted out.
That is our week supply. And then we've got, a functioning sink. It's got a bathroom as well.
Oh, wow.
And then storage, all the different things that you would need to do something.
Practical van. It's not just a show van. It's like a practical van as well, on top of looking amazing.
And that's what, the end user for this is actually a guy that owns a camper dealership.
Ah.
So the beauty of him is he knows what he wants. You know, he gave us just the baseline of what he wanted, and it said, do your thing.
Absolutely.
So that was fun.
That's really nice.
And then we also got this where you can basically lay this down, and then this can be a sleeper.
Oh, wow. Well. That's super cool.
Yeah, so that basically allows you to do that.
That's superb.
Yeah.
And the seats, panels and stuff, that was all...
This was open like this in the other camper. The transition between here and there was a little bit of a deal because there's so much of a space between here. So we actually ended up having to, you know, make these panels and do all this type of stuff just so it kind of blends in with this interior.
Yeah, that's right.
These seats are original to the truck. Dash panel or the door panels are the same way. And what we did is we just cut down these seats, and so it wasn't such a high back to them. And then it's just, standard after that. We didn't go crazy with it because we just wanted it to be just simple.
Well, that is absolutely superb. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Is there anybody else involved in it that you need to like shout out or anything, or give recognition to?
Our biggest thing is with PPG, the support that they gave us on there was, basically it's like, what do you need to make this thing happen? The wheels and stuff like that, we used Delmo wheels, Curtis Speed, they actually machined the wheels for us.
Oh, nice.
We have a really strong, long list of people that we deal with. You know, coming back to SEMA is ultimately what we want to do. We want to basically create this groundwork that, we'll be back here for next year.
Well, your work is superb. So.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I really appreciate it.
Actually, not that many people knows, but 8086 is my favorite car.